The Pets for Life model, the whole concept is, you know, when you help someone's pet, you're helping them. Because they want to do what's right for their animal. Sometimes they don't have the resources, or in most cases, they don't have the resources.
The main focus of everything we do is to help that pet owner. And that's been a big change, especially when we're dealing with people that the staff may not have thought made good pet owners.
I instantly knew it was what was needed in our community. So then I bring it back to my friends, my family, my colleagues, and even some from my board of directors. Said, well, we're not going to that neighborhood.
There's, you know, all these preconceived notions in some of these underserved communities where we're rescuing, where, you know, it's dangerous.
Within 2 weeks, I was told 5 times I was going to get shot by my loved ones and colleagues. Once you're out there, you feel safe because everybody invites you in, and they're cooking food, and they're open arms, and they're hugging you, even the ones that don't have pets.
I'm an introvert, so going and knocking on doors is not something I ever really thought I would be doing, but I love it. And now I don't think twice about yelling down the street to someone or going and knocking on their door.
When you hit the streets and, you know, you make a connection with a family, and then, you know, the neighbor, and then the guy, you know, around the corner, and, you know, they hug you when they see you. That's something that stays with you.
There was a woman who had all these chihuahuas, and she'd been breeding them, little playpens almost for each of the chihuahuas, and they were always mating with each other, and dads and moms and babies, and she found out from a neighbor 2 doors down that I was there, and she was so excited, you know, to be able to stop the breeding because she realized she just couldn't do it anymore.
People are actually wanting to do more for their pets because they're realizing that there are people that are there to help, which they never had before.
You come back at the end of the day when you're transporting animals back, and the first couple of times I came back, there were whole families waiting in the living room. Like, and they would see that I pulled up, and people just stopped, like, walking from all over the block to come see what a gadget looked like when he came back.
It seems like they feel like they're being heard, and I think that's hugely important. And get thank you notes. People sent us, I think, some dollar bills in an envelope. Thank you so much for taking care of our cat at the clinic. That means so much to us.
People really do care, and they really do care about each other. And the only way we know that, and it's by being out there. And it's been a life-changing experience for the entire staff.
It's the most real, the best thing I've been a part of.
Just the words Pets for Life, they mean so much. So I had it tattooed on my arm here, and you're walking on sunshine that evening heading home from work. You know, that's that jackpot you've been waiting for, and it happens every single day.
Well, I think what really does make this grant unique is it's not just the funding. Having the mentorship available to us to help us get through hurdles or challenges that we meet in this program is just so valuable.
This program actually started with data and has the data to show that this works, that it is successful, that animals are being reached who have never been to the vet before. Dogs are being spayed in families that have never spayed pets before, and all their future dogs are going to be spayed. This works, and the data shows it.
It's something that can change society and how people see pets and how they take care of them in the long run.
You're starting to see some shifts in a community and leaving behind something that I think that is sustainable for that community.
I mean, it helps if I spay and neuter a Yorkie, but when I spay and neuter a pit bull that's going to have 10, 12 pups, and those pups are having pups, I mean, that's just revolutionary to me, and that whole concept. And I've been struggling for, I don't know, 5, 6 years. How do I do that? How do I reach out to these people? Pets for Life came in and said, well, here's how you do it. I think this is life-changing for the whole movement.